I've spoken to the Jacob Blaise family several times, and my guess is I'll be seeing them or speaking to them. I'm going to meet with the business community, as well as hopefully some law enforcement, as well as some of the people who feel very aggrieved up there. I've spent my whole career trying to bring people together and been able to do that in the past. And so this is about unifying people, not dividing us. What I'd do on day one is I would continue to bring folks together. I've done this my whole career. You know, the vast majority of law enforcement officers, women and men, are decent, honorable people. When they put that shield on in the morning, they become targets as well. But there's some bad cops, and they want to get rid of bad cops as well as anyone else wants to get rid of bad cops. And protesting is a right, and it should not be curtailed. But protesting does not include burning or looting or shooting somebody. And there's never, and it should be prosecuted when it occurs. About bringing people together, I'm going to be meeting with some business people. I'm going to be meeting with folks in the community who are the religious leaders in the community, and do what you would do in any circumstance like this. I've done it before in my home city and other places. Bring all the parties together and say, we can work this out. Let's work this out peacefully and rationally. That's what I'm going to try to do.
How will you know that that message is resonating with people? Because it seems like people only hear what they want to hear. They've already made up their minds. How will you reach over on both sides?
Well, I think, you know, the talk about people having made up their minds, if you notice, since both conventions are over, we've made significant movement with an awful lot of people who have an open mind, are saying, because, well, look, the question that was asked before, you know, years ago, you know, are you better off than you were 4 years ago? Well, you know, the question is, you know, if 4 more years of Donald Trump going to change anything? Does anybody believe anything's going to change? That he's going to possibly bring the country together? That he's going to deal with the thing that people fear most, COVID, that people fear most about not being able to make it through in terms of their economic circumstance? I mean, there's just been a total abdication of leadership here. And so this is about trying to bring people together. And that's what I've done my whole career as a senator, as a vice president, Democrats and Republicans. You cannot govern the country without arriving at a consensus. And that's what we can do. We can. The possibilities in America are overwhelming, the things we're able to do. We not only can come back, we can come back better than we were before.
And you speak a lot about leadership, and it's important at this time because, you know, we're here in Central Florida, the I-4 corridor, and we've had more than 600,000 cases of COVID-19. And you just talked about reopening schools. We had a case of a school opening and having to close down within days, if not just a week or so after opening. What do you say needed to be done about opening the school so the teachers feel safe, the students feel safe, and the staff feel safe?
I laid out a detailed plan back in June and July. Go to joebiden.com. But here's the deal. In order to open, you have to be in a community where the infection rate is down, number one, not eliminated, down. Number two, you have to provide the school districts with the means to be able to open safely, with the PPE, with the equipment they need, with ventilation systems that in fact redistribute the air, making sure that there's social distancing, smaller classes requiring more faculty. This is FEMA started off, the emergency management operation started off providing funding for schools to be able to open. The superintendents nationwide point out they'll need about $200 billion to open safely. Why aren't we doing that? This is a national emergency. Why aren't we doing that? Mr. President, what one thing have you done? One thing you've done to get schools open safely? And look at all the parents out there. I don't know whether you're a parent or not, but you're working. If you are a parent and you're wondering, your kid's going to go back to school. If they can't go back to school, what are you going to do? We should be dealing with letting daycare centers know what they have to do to be in a position they can open safely. And look at what's happened. The enormous pressure put on the CDC not to put out the detailed guidelines. The enormous pressure being put on the FDA to say that the following protocol will in fact reduce that will have a giant impact on COVID. All these things turn out not to be true. And when a president continues to mislead and lie, when we finally do, God willing, get a vaccine, who's going to take the shot? Who's going to take the shot? You can be the first one to say, put me, sign me up. They now say it's okay. I'm not being facetious. Franklin Roosevelt said a different thing in the middle of the beginning of World War II. I'm gonna paraphrase him. He said, things are gonna get worse and worse and worse before they get better and better and better. But the American people are tough. You gotta give it to them straight from the shoulder. They can handle anything. We should give it to the American people straight from the shoulder.
Are you coming to Orlando anytime soon? And will you come and see us?
That is my intention. What I'm gonna do is follow the science though. Follow the science and make sure what I do is consistent with making sure we deal with the one thing people are afraid of. They're afraid of dying or getting ill from COVID. That is a responsibility of a leader to make sure you do it responsibly. That is my intention to be in Orlando, my intention to be in Florida, because look, in Florida, what's happening in Florida? I mean, you have a president of the United States who just introduced a proposal to wipe out Social Security. The head of the actuarial at Department of Social Security said, if his plan for Social Security goes forward, the entire fund will be depleted by the middle of 2023. There's a lot I want to talk about and point out to the people in Florida that they have to focus on to be able to make sure they are protected across the board in terms of their economy, their Social Security, their jobs, as well as their health. But I'm looking forward to seeing you. I really am.
Mr. Vice President, thank you so much for your time. It's been a pleasure.